It's Phil Eastwood here. Welcome to the 26th edition of our Living Leadership Weekly Message, focused on those things that you can do right now to grow your influence and impact on those around you. But it's especially about growing yourself. We publish each Living Leadership episode in a variety of ways and on a variety of platforms, enabling you to either read, watch, or listen to it. Each episode is no more than a few minutes long, making it simple for you to digest, action, and share with those that you feel may benefit from its content. Here is this week's personal development piece. We've certainly had requests recently for more of a narrative about workplace civility and respect. So that's what I focused this week's section on. Civil and respectful interactions between colleagues in the workplace bring invaluable benefits to an organization. These benefits are not only likely to produce a range of positive outcomes that will have a tremendous impact on a workplace's culture, but they will also greatly influence employee satisfaction levels across the board. The list of benefits that civil and respectful interactions bring to a workplace is significant and includes high levels of company morale, a greater sense of job satisfaction, a more resilient and cohesive team, increased collaboration, consistent levels of productivity, motivated employees who are happy to go above and beyond, and perhaps unsurprisingly, low turnover and absenteeism, which everyone benefits from. So how can we all be productive and play a central role in the amount of respect and civility that exists in our workplace? Here are some tips. A good start is to show your colleagues that they are really appreciated and valued. If you have faith in what they do, make sure that they know this. Do your part to help create an environment that nurtures individual insight, cooperative brainstorming, and creativity. The end result is a confident workplace where we are motivated and feel we are contributing to a company's bottom line and success. We also believe we are a part of an essential team, embrace different perspectives. People have different viewpoints and need to believe their opinions matter. Respecting and encouraging the individuality of every colleague creates a safe environment where individuals are comfortable being themselves. It also creates a platform for individuals to freely share their ideas and insight. An organization that places respect for diversity at the top of its list enjoys the many benefits of a cohesive workforce. We all play a role in helping people feel that their ideas matter. It all comes down to the interchange between each one of us and the basic tenet of treating others the way that you would like to be treated. It's simple, really. Practice civility every day. Civility is about people using their manners, being courteous and polite. It's about people being aware of the rights, concerns, and feelings of others. Go out of your way to extend courteous, gracious, and respectful behavior to the people you work with every day. Be mindful when providing feedback to those around you. Do you know what triggers you? Hopefully you do. But do you know what triggers others? Chances are you don't. The suggestion here is twofold. First, always aim to be carefully monitoring your own speech and behavior when reacting to feedback. If you aren't entirely sure, try to understand what triggers negative or defensive reactions in yourself so you have control over your weak moments. Secondly, try to always be careful during any kind of interaction with others when you are providing feedback and not speaking perhaps without thinking first. Understand that we are all susceptible to our weak moments, particularly when we feel defensive and hurt during feedback, even during moments of jest and levity. Remember, we don't always get a second chance to unsay something. Consider the potential impact of your message. We all need to consider the impact our words and actions have on others before we act. Too often, communication in the form of emails or text messages is sent out without really taking the time to consider the different possible ways such communication can be interpreted. Taking a few seconds to consider the impact of your message can help to prevent an unintended situation and unnecessary hurt feelings. Accept responsibility when things go wrong as well. It's a given that we all need to accept responsibility for our actions and be aware of the consequences of those actions when we are not at our best. But what does this mean? Well, first of all, it means that we are only human after all, and we can't be 100% on our game all the time. It's important that we acknowledge our imperfect behavior to ourselves and to others as we seek ways to improve, rectify, and prevent these same mistakes from reoccurring. We all have a role to play in maintaining civil and respectful workplaces. What you do today influences what your colleagues do tomorrow. Multiply these actions over the course of 6 months and you can either end up with a wonderful place to work or potentially the opposite, and we all want the former. What book am I reading this week? Well, I'm reading TED Talks, the official TED Guide to Public Speaking by Chris Anderson. There is a great quote in this book which states that presentation literacy isn't an optional extra for a few. It's a core skill for the 21st century. I've always been interested in growing as a communicator, and we use several TED Talk videos in our leadership skills training program. Public speaking, done well, can be the key to unlocking empathy, stirring excitement, sharing knowledge, and promoting a shared dream. And who wouldn't want to do more of that? In his book, Chris Anderson recommends that you first of all treat the tips in its pages as tools, not rules, to develop your own unique style of public speaking, and covers it in four key areas. Start with the right foundation. Develop your ideas. Preparation and delivery time. There are hundreds of ways to give a talk, and everyone can find an approach that's right for them, and then learn the necessary skills to do it well. If you are interested in growing and learning as I am, then I highly recommend turning its pages. This week's smile is a very short scene from the Captain Marvel movie, which features a lesson in understanding and appreciating your own worth and being given an opportunity to show it. Punch in Captain Marvel, Carol Danvers' I Have Nothing to Prove scene to your video search engine and sit back and smile knowingly to yourself. My call to action for you this week. Well, think back to the suggestions that I made earlier about treating people with civility and respect, and let them know how much you value them. Well, I hope you enjoyed this week's Living Leadership. Stay tuned for another message next week, and in the meantime, please stay healthy and safe.